Welcome to StarnFX. I'm Eran, and in this tutorial, we'll see how to work with placeholders and proxies inside After Effects. The beauty of this series named Speed Up After Effects is that you can watch it in any order you like. Maybe I'm going to offer it to Netflix. Oh wait, they already have something similar. So never mind. What's more important is that we have another way to make After Effects more responsive, and this is the same method the big guns compositing apps are using, meaning render as you go. In other words, if you created a complex composition, instead of keeping it live and ask After Effects to process each part of it, you can turn it into a proxy file and even use this proxy when you're ready to export your final result. But as always, there are a few caveats in the way, so let's see the process and how to make the most out of it. So this is the scenario. I have a composition that I already started cooking. I'm just going to play it for you. You can see there are a few plates here in 3D space. So these are these Illustrator files. And there is a message, a little bit of a stressful message, that T800 is back. Now, let's say that I don't yet have the model of the T800 robot, but I want to temporarily substitute it for a footage item. If this is the case, I can use either a placeholder or a proxy. So let's start with a placeholder, which is just a still image of color bars used to temporarily take the place of a missing footage item or something that you don't have yet. We can use this placeholder when we are building a composition like this and we want to try out ideas for a footage item that is not yet available. Now, After Effects is going to generate placeholders automatically for you, so you don't need to provide a placeholder footage item. And the way to do it is to go to the File menu, and then under Import, choose Placeholder. And this is going to show you this dialog. I'm just going to name this guy Robot. I can set the size of it, any size will do, but this is sampling the size of this composition, as well as the frame rate. So right now I'm working on a 24 frames per second and the duration is set to 10 seconds, but of course you can change it anytime you like. I'll click OK over here. It's going to create this missing footage or placeholder over here in the project panel. And now I can drag it, let's say, under this title, maybe also turn it to a 3D layer. And then if I'll press P, I can also push this behind the text, something like this, just to remind me that this is where the footage should be. Of course, I can continue to work with it, maybe scale it, move it to the right, do whatever I want. And when I have the footage ready, I can replace it. All right, so I'll close this guy and let's fast forward in time, let's say 1 hour, to the place that you already have the final thing ready. So I'll switch to this composition, T800 is back. And over here, as you can see, I already have all the render demanding layers in place. Now I'm using here third-party effects, such as Form and Mirror from the Trapcode family. And I'll put a link to the Trapcode package if you want to check it out over at maxon.net. But anyhow, I want to just simplify this composition so it will be more responsive. And to do it, I'm going to use a proxy. But before doing so, I just want to define what is a proxy. So a proxy can be any file which we are using temporarily to replace a footage item or a composition. Sometimes it can be a lower resolution version or a still version of the existing footage that we are using to replace the original. Now, often, storyboard images are being used as proxies. And you can use a proxy either before you have the final footage or when you have the actual footage items, like we have in this example, if you want to speed up previewing or rendering for test purposes. Now, I just want to remind you that all masks, attributes, expressions, effects, keyframes, everything that you are going to apply to the layer are going to be retained when we are going to replace this placeholder or proxy with the final footage item. Okay, so now that I've established what it means, let me show you how to create it. And to make sure that I know which layers to choose, I want to use the composition profiler, so Oscar the Snail here. I'll click on it, and it's going to show us the render time column. And if you want to know more about it, make sure to check my tutorial about the composition profiler. But I'm going to skip ahead and tell you that everything which is amber or orange is probably going to slow down the render process, which means that the expensive layer, or the rendering demanding layers in this case, are the particles layers and probably some of the other layers that we can see over here. So we can check this in few places. Let's go over here and let's see it over here as well, so we can get a sense of which layers we need to take under account. All right, so in this case, what I would like to do is select layer number 6, layer number 7, as well as those two layers, 10 and 12, that I've used to create the 3D model, as well as the blue-silver texture. So all of these layers cause the composition to be less responsive. So what I will do is go to the layer menu and then choose pre-compose. I'm going to name this guy Robot, and by guy I mean this new composition. We can also adjust the composition duration to the time span of the selected layers. It's always a good idea, especially in this case. And let's also open it. So I'll click OK. And this is how it looks over here. Totally wrong. And the reason is because we also need to copy the camera and those two lights, the point and the spotlight, from this composition. So I'll select them and press Command or Control C to copy them to the memory. And then go to the beginning and paste the camera and the lights. And now we can see that we have a similar appearance. And of course, if we want, we can preview it over here. But what I would like to do now is select this comp here in the project panel and go to the file menu. And under create proxy, I'll choose movie. And this is going to open up the render queue of After Effects. Before you're going to click on render, I think you may want to check the render settings as well as the output model, because by default, when you are selecting this option, After Effects is going to create a low resolution proxy for you. You can see draft settings over here. So the first thing that I would like to do is change it to best settings. And then for the output model, instead of what it says over here, I'm going to click on this down pointing arrow and choose high quality with alpha. And I'm also going to click on it over here just to show you that it's going to use the Apple ProRes 4444 and it's going to embed the alpha channel in the video. Now, this is very important. I also need to change the post-render action if I want After Effects to recognize this as a proxy. So I will change it to set proxy over here and I'll click OK. And finally, I'll click on the name and make sure that I know where I'm saving it. So in this case, I'll save it to the desktop over here and I'll click render. So this is going to take some time to render. In my case, I think it's going to take around a minute, but it will pay off so much later. So once the render has been finished, you can see in the composition viewer a red label on the bottom of the screen with the words proxy enabled. So if I'll switch to this composition and I'll scrub it, this now becomes a footage. You can also see here in the project panel that instead of the composition type, this is now set to a QuickTime. And when it's selected, you'll see the original one as well as the proxy details. So you can see that there is a filled box indicating that a proxy item is currently in use throughout the project. If I'll click on this, it's going to turn off the proxy, and an empty box indicates that the footage item, or in this case, the original layers inside the composition, are being used throughout the project. So I can tick again the box and reassign the proxy, meaning I can connect between them. And if I want to assign another file or maybe set it completely to none, I can select the project item over here, go to the file menu, and then under set proxy, I can choose another file or I can set it to none, which is just going to dismiss the entire process. I'll undo the last operation because I do want to show you the difference. I do want to use this proxy, and I'll switch back to the composition that I worked on. So remember, this one now is using this composition. And if I'll move my time indicator, you can see that it becomes much more quicker to scrub the timeline as well as to just preview the entire thing. So this is really going to help us test some maybe color correction or different stuff that we want to apply to the other layers, having all the expensive layers already been rendered as a proxy. This can also be very useful if you want to hand over this project to someone that doesn't have access to the plugins that you've used, in this case, Trapcode Form and Mirror. Now, if you want, you can also return to the beginning state. This is where we use the placeholder, and I can select the placeholder here in the project panel, right-click on him this time, and I can replace this with a footage, or I can set this one as a proxy as well. So let's choose set proxy file. Notice there is a keyboard shortcut of Command Option P here on the Mac. This will be Control Alt P on the Windows side. It's going to open up your Explorer or Finder window, and then we can assign this layer. And now this one becomes part of this composition. The last thing that we want to do is to render this comp. And again, there is a bit of a gotcha here. So I just want to show you the render process. So let's say that we want to render it with the proxy enabled. For that, I'll go to the composition menu and choose add to render queue. And I need to click this time on the render settings. So I'll click on best settings, and over here, notice you have a proxy use option. So by default, After Effects is not going to use proxies. It's actually going to use the original file. So in our case, the original composition when you are rendering this one. So if you want to use the proxies, meaning that you have a high resolution, high quality proxies, you can do it by either changing to current settings, and this is going to take the settings that you have in the project. So if the proxy is enabled, it's going to use the proxy, or you can just tell it to use all proxies, depending on what you want. You've got a few other options as well. All right, so I'll click OK over here. I'm going to leave everything as is. I'm just going to visit this composition and switch on the audio, because I do want to play you the final one with the audio that I've created. And finally, I'll click render to show you how fast it is to render the same composition this time with the proxy enabled. It took us a fraction of the time to render this, so 19 seconds in this case. And if I'll right click on the output model, I can choose reveal in Finder, which is just going to show me this file. And then I can double click on it and play it to you full screen. And this is how you can use placeholders and proxies to be more efficient and also speed up After Effects. This methodology is used with high-end compositing software like Nuke and Flame on film and commercial work all the time. When something looks good, render the comp to disk and use this file as your base layer. As always, if this information was useful, please like this video and also consider subscribing to the channel. And of course, I want to thank you personally for watching this tutorial, and I will see you soon in the next one.